Hi guys, in today's video, I will show you how to fix the common errors search invalid after you enforcing. This happened after you enforcing HTTPS on your Nextcloud servers. If you follow my tutorial on FreeNAS 11.3 on how to enforcing HTTPS, this should be really easy and straightforward instructions on how to fix it. So if after enforcing HTTPS and you try to access the admin portal, this only happen if you're using a Google Chrome or Brave, which is exactly the same like Google Chrome, but it's just more privacy focused. And as you see, I'm using a TrueNAS Core. Not recommend you upgrading to it yet. It's still under beta testing. It's not for production environment yet, so I still recommend you to stick with FreeNAS 11.3 until TrueNAS stable version release. However, TrueNAS Core is still running on FreeBSD, so it's pretty much the same as FreeNAS 11.3. Alright, so when you try to access the admin portal, you're gonna experience the net error search invalid. And this is not because you have incorrect configurations or something wrong with your FreeNAS or TrueNAS, but it's because Google not accepting the cell sizes certificate. All we just have to do is manually verify the cell size certificate. And or if you don't want to do that, this only happened for Google Chrome, like I said earlier. So if you have Firefox, you can access this with Firefox just fine. And when you access it using Firefox, it's gonna say connection insecure. You're gonna go to advanced and you're gonna add the exception. And we're gonna confirm. And there we go. You're able to access your Nextcloud servers. Now we're gonna go back to Google Chrome, and if you follow my tutorial and you follow exactly my instructions, then this should be easy. If not, then you need to figure out where you store the certificate. So I store my certificate in the user local etc SSL and nginx. So we're gonna go ahead and open up that folder on FreeNAS or TrueNAS in this case. Alright, so I'm gonna go to IO cache and then I go to jails Nextcloud. And it should be under root and then users. And what is it again? Local etc nginx. Should be etc SSL and nginx. Here we go. This is the certificate. So we're gonna go ahead and copy that certificate and we're gonna put it in that top. Alright. And we're gonna open the keychain access and we're gonna add the new certificate in there. Nextcloud.crt, and it's gonna ask you to enter your password. Alright, so now if you see an X, would mean that the root certificate is not trusted, so we're gonna double click on that one and manually trust it, this certificate, and we're gonna be always trust and we're gonna close it out. And you're gonna ask you to enter your password again. And now you have a blue plus sign, which means that it manually trusted for all users. I'm gonna go back and refresh the Chrome. And there you go, you're able to access it. And before I wrap up my tutorial, guys, I just want to say that thank you for everybody that have been subscribing to my channel. If you think this helpful, please don't forget to subscribe and like. And coming up, I will have the new video tutorial on how to set up the DDNS or dynamic DNS so that you can access your Nextcloud remotely. So I added my website on the YouTube channel. If you click on the W icon right here, it's gonna take you to my website. And I posted a instruction on how to set up the cloud DNS, set up a dynamic DNS with the cloud DNS. This is one of the steps you need to do before we can get your Nextcloud enabled. You're able to access this remotely, and this I will show you how to do this on the next video, hopefully sometime this week. And until then, I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye bye.